memories is taking a trip to the Elizabethtown Cemetery with my sisters and my grandparents. We looked at the engraved stone wall, the many headstones, and enjoyed the view of the city from the very top of the hill. They showed us this big black cannon that sat off to the side, its barrel pointing towards the city. Shortly after, we drove up the road to the Elizabethtown Square, where a bright blue building showcased an arrow pointing to a cannonball stuck in the side of the wall. I remember being intrigued by it even as a kid, and seeing it every time we drove by it over the years. Now, as many years have gone by, I think back to that memory and wonder about the history behind it. While the blue building has been painted over and the cannonball removed, the story of the Elizabethtown Christmas raid is one that I still find very interesting. Elizabethtown was founded in July of 1797. Over time, the area transformed from forts and blockhouses used as stockades for defense against Native Americans to a heavily populated town. The opening of the Louisville and Nashville Railroad in 1854 brought even more civilization. The success of the L&N Railroad is what made this community such a strategic point in the Civil War. In December of 1862, the rebel army made its way to Tennessee after the Confederate forces failed to hold them in Perryville, Kentucky. They got word that the Union general was planning a winter campaign as soon as they had enough supplies collected in Nashville. To stop the flow of materials through the Louisville and Nashville Railroad, General Braxton Bragg contacted the newly appointed General John Hunt Morgan to break the supply line with an artillery attack in Kentucky before the materials got to the Union troops in Tennessee. On December 22nd, General Morgan led his troop of about 4,000 from where they were camped in Alexandria, Tennessee, towards Tompkinsville, Kentucky. About 90% of Morgan's command were born in Kentucky and had not been home since they enlisted. Being back on their homeland gave the soldiers a boost of joy and pride to continue their fight against Federal forces. They continued to travel through Glasgow, across the Green River, and camped outside of Upton on Christmas Day. On the morning of December 27th, General Morgan's troops set up in what is now the Elizabethtown Cemetery. Lieutenant Colonel Harry S. Smith was planning to lead his small federal troop of 650 into the attack against Morgan's 4,000. He tried to trick Morgan into believing there were more federal troops than there actually were by sending a letter stating that Morgan's troops were surrounded and that he should immediately surrender. However, Morgan didn't fall for the tricks and gave the town 30 minutes to evacuate. Once the Confederates began their attack plan, all Colonel Smith could do was delay the inevitable. Smith's troops were greatly outnumbered and eventually were forced to surrender. Although the original building struck by the cannon in 1862 was burned down, the cannonball was salvaged and placed on the new building in its approximate original strike spot in 1877. The story of the Christmas raid on the hills of the Elizabethtown Cemetery is one that I was interested in long before I even knew about it. Staring up at the cannonball stuck in the walls of the town square is the memory I still hold dear after all these years. Knowing the small piece of history behind it makes my hometown just a little bit more interesting.